I've had so many incredible nights in this building. A couple of them spring to mind. One was a concert after 9/11, which was such an incredibly emotional and amazing experience in the worst circumstances. But another was in the most joyous of circumstances. It was on the 28th of November in 1974. And we were joined on stage by a petrified John Lennon, who kept his side of the bargain, and because the record that we made together went to number one, he agreed to come on stage. And to be honest with you, I've never heard a reception for anyone like that in my life when he came. It still gives me goosebumps, and it still makes me very, very sad and happy at the same time, because we all know what happened a few years later. And I only ever sing this song at this place, because it's the only place that it's appropriate to sing it, and it's too upsetting for me to sing it anywhere else. But this is called Empty Garden, in the memory of one of the world's most incredible men, musicians, songwriters, and John Lennon.
What happened here at the New York sunset disappeared? I found an empty garden among the flagstones there. Left here, he must have been a gardener that cared a lot, who weeded out the tears and grew a good crop. Now it all looks strange. It's funny how I'm insect can damage so much grain. Little empty garden by the brownstone door, and in the cracks along the sidewall, nothing grows no more. Ooh, left here, he must have been a gardener that cared a lot, who weeded out the tears and grew a good crop. And we are so amazed. A gardener like that one, no one can replace. And I've been knocking, but no one answers. I've been knocking most of the day. Oh, I've been calling.
If only he